Shoulder to shoulder and ready to fight. One of these four candidates is set to be Japan's next Prime Minister.
自民党が国民の声を聞き
I'm running for the Liberal Democratic Party leadership election to show that the LDP listens to the people and to protect our nation's democracy.
Former Foreign Minister Fumio Kishida lost to Yoshihide Suga in the previous election. He says a government led by him will prioritise transparency and accountability and will restore unity for Japan's post-pandemic future.
Well, one day I will be the Prime Minister.
Popular frontrunner Taro Kono is a familiar face on the political scene. Leading the vaccination rollout, the fluent English speaker has broad appeal across age groups, though might find it difficult to distance himself from criticism of the current leadership.
Whether the lawmakers cast a vote based on their own groups or be responsive to the public opinion, the way they do politics and its governance will be changed depending on who will be the Prime Minister of Japan.
Unusually, two women are also in the running, though they have to win over a conservative and largely male governing party, a task former Gender Equality Minister Seiko Noda is used to.
Women are in the extreme minority in politics. The gender ratio of the voters is 50-50. I believe that having the same number in politics can create a good balance, so let's work on it together.
A slightly more likely female pick, ex-Internal Affairs Minister Sane Takaichi, a close associate of former Prime Minister Shinzo Abe. The known right-winger is pushing to strengthen Japan's armed forces. But she's already angered some by visiting a controversial shrine honouring Japan's war dead, including convicted war criminals.
We need to think there is a high potential of a Taiwan Strait emergency and be prepared. But there is a limit to what Japan can do militarily.
Whoever wins the September 29 vote faces falling voter ratings over the handling of COVID-19 as well as a struggling economy. Andreini Hoff, ABC News.